Hey guys, welcome back to a new video by Biology with Zhang Xuan. So today we are going to do the 0610/23 May-June 2023 Paper 2 Multiple Choice Extended. So the link of this paper will be in the description box below and make sure you check it out. So let's begin solving this paper. Okay, question 1. What are the two characteristics of all living organisms? So living organisms means two characteristics means Mrs. Grant. Okay, so which one is correct will be C, reproduction and respiration. All right, question 2. The photograph shows an organism. Which visible feature can be used to classify this organism as a bird? Which it lays egg. No, not lays egg. It has feathers. Sorry, because the reptile also can lay eggs. Question 3. Which statement about cell structure is correct? A bacterium has a cell wall. B. Okay. Because an animal cell doesn't have a cell wall, they only have a cell membrane. And an animal cell has no chloroplast. A bacterium also has no chloroplast. Question 4. The diameter of an egg cell from a frog is 2.5 millimeters. The diameter of an egg cell from a human is 120 micrometers. Which value shows approximately how many times larger an egg cell from a frog is than an egg cell from a human? Okay, so convert the 2.5 mm into micrometers, which is 2.5 times 1000, which you get 2500 micrometer. So use 2500 divided by 120. This will give you the how many times it's larger, which is 20.833, which is equivalent to 21. So the answer is B. Question 5. When a plant cell is put into pure water, it gains water by osmosis and becomes turgid. So the answer is B. Question 6. The graph shows the result of an investigation to the effect of oxygen on the uptake of glucose by cells. Which conclusion can be made about these data? So, glucose enters the cell by both active transport and diffusion. Okay, because when it's no oxygen, right, the graph also still has a line there. Okay, so it's not flat. If it's flat, then only active transport will happen. But since there's also a line for no oxygen, therefore diffusion also is able to work. Okay, question 7. The table shows the result of food tests carried out on fruit. What did the fruit contain? So it's positive Benedict and positive Burette, but negative ethanol and negative iodine. So Benedict's solution is the test for reducing sugars, and Burette is the test for protein. So the answer is C. Question 8. What describes the structure of a DNA? So they want the structure. They don't want you to tell like what's inside of a DNA. So the answer for this question is D. Two strands of coil to form a double helix. Because double helix is the structure of a DNA. That is how it looks like. Question 9. The statements are about enzymes. 1. Enzymes are catalysts. Correct. Enzymes are proteins. Correct. Enzymes are used up during chemical reactions. No. They are not used up by the chemical reaction and they can be reused all over again. So the answer is B. Question 10. When the temperature increases, the rate of an enzyme catalyzed reaction increases until the optimum temperature is reached. Which statement explains why the rate increases? So, of course, if you know this from physics, when temperature increases, the kinetic energy increases, therefore more collision happens. So the answer for this question would be C. Okay, so the enzyme and substrate have more kinetic energy and collide more frequently. Okay, question 11. A plant with variegated leaf was placed in a dark cardboard for 48 hours so that all of the starch was removed from the leaves. The variegated leaves have green parts and white parts. Black paper was then fixed on one leaf and the plant was exposed to light. After 24 hours, which region of the leaf contains starch? So the answer for this is C. Because you can see the green part can be tested for such due to chloroplast. Question 12. The graph shows the rate of photosynthesis with increasing light intensity. Where is the light intensity a limiting factor for photosynthesis? Always when it's increasing much larger. So it will be here and here. Okay, so between 1 and 2. Question 13. In humans, which two components of a diet can be broken down to release energy? Carbohydrates and fats. This is quite common sense. We all know that carbohydrates is for releasing energy and fat is like a energy sparer. It means that when there's not enough carbohydrates in your body, they will use the fat to use it up as energy. Question 14. Which is part of a small intestine? So the answer will be B, ileum. So the colon is the large intestine. Okay, just to note that. And other of esophagus and rectum is another parts of the alimentary canal. Question 15. Which combination of environmental factors will cause the largest increase in transpiration rate in a plant? So it has to be high wind speed, low humidity, high temperature, and high intensity. So the answer is B. Question 16. The diagram represents a movement of substances between plant cells. The arrows indicate the direction of substance is moving in. Which diagram of translocation is correctly labeled? So we must know that when glucose is produced, right, they act as a source. So the glucose becomes the source. And of course, when it goes back, it goes back down to the roots, for example, the sinks will be roots. The direction will go downwards, not upwards, because the phloem is only one direction, okay? So from here, we know that we can only transport glucose in the form of sucrose. So the answer for this will be C, okay? Question 17. The diagram shows a section of a human heart. Okay, which label identifies the right ventricle? So remember, here is the left, here is the right. So the answer is D, okay? Question 18. The diagram shows sections of three types of blood vessels. They are not drawn to the same scale. In which order will red blood cells flow through these vessels in the human body when traveling from the aorta to the right atrium of the heart? So it's basically from the left side to the right side of the heart. So what does it pass through? So first thing from this question, label what is this first. So this is the arteries. This is the capillaries. And this is the veins. So he has to go from arteries, capillaries, then the veins. So the answer is B. Question 19. When a person is given a vaccine, a harmless pathogen is injected. The pathogen has antigens, which cause lymphocytes to produce antibodies. This is an example of active immunity. So the answer is A. Question 20. What happens when the person breathes in? So this is a process of inspiration. Okay, which you should be familiar with this. So the external intercostal muscles will contract and the internal intercostal muscles will relax. So the answer is D. Question 21. Which graph shows the effect of temperature on enzyme activity? So this is straightforward. You must know that the graph looks like this in C, where it goes up in a peak. There's one peak here, and then it goes down and begins to denature. Okay. Question 22. After running a fast race, some students have pains in their leg muscle due to a buildup of lactic acid. A student wrote this explanation. During the race, the cells did not have enough oxygen for aerobic respiration. Correct? Because this is the process of anaerobic ready now. Okay. Anaerobic respiration occurs, so some energy is released from glucose. Yes, because glucose is also a reactant for anaerobic respiration. The lactic acid is produced by aerobic? No, it's produced by anaerobic. Okay, so the answer is A. Question 23. What is the name of the process that produces urea and the organ where the urea is formed? C, deamination and the liver, because denitrification is not here. It should be in the nitrogen cycle. So deamination is the process and the liver is where it produces the urea, okay? Question 24, the diagram shows the gap between two neurons. One is the name of X. So X is the those tiny little dots here that they were pointing. So they are neurotransmitter. Question 25, which statement are correct for cone cells in the eye? So they detect color, yeah, for this one. So cone cells are located at the fovea of the retina. That's correct. Cone cells detect color? Nope. Cone cells are more sensitive to light than rod cells? Nope. It should be rod cells being more sensitive than cone cells. So the answer is B. Question 26, the diagram shows the structure of a human skin. Which structure constricts to reduce heat loss? B, these are the main arteries that control blood flow. When there's more blood flow, they want to reduce the heat loss, okay? Question 27, where are the hormones estrogen and progesterone produced during pregnancy? It's by the placenta. You should be familiar with this, okay? Question 28, the umbilical artery takes blood from the fetus to the placenta. The umbilical vein carries blood from the placenta to the fetus. How do the contents of the umbilical artery differ from the dose of the umbilical vein? So you can see that they want the umbilical artery. So it's from placenta to fetus, okay? Sorry, this is from fetus to placenta. Meaning the baby is returning the stuff back to the mother. So this, of course, will be more carbon dioxide, lesser oxygen, and more urea. They want fetus to placenta, okay? Question 29, which rule shows some of the features involved in natural selection? Many offspring are produced, correct. Human choose desired features, nope, this should be selective, okay? And then alleles are passed on to the offspring, yes, correct. The answer is D. So this should be artificial selection, okay. Question 30, which substance is coded by a length of DNA? It's not gene, this should be lipase, okay. So this two keyword is the most important. Which substance is coded, okay. Question 31, the diagram shows the sex chromosome of a woman and of a man. The genotype of a recessive sex-linked condition also shown. What are the chances that their daughter will show the sex-linked condition? So, you have to draw. Okay, so I will draw the woman first, which is XA. Oh no, that's wrong. XA, XA, and this will be XAY. So, it will be XA, XA. X A X A, and here will be X A Y and X A Y. So the answer for this question, you see the same and then same here. So the answer will be 50%. Okay. Okay, question 32. Which Punnett square shows the sum of the test cross that identifies a heterozygous parent? So of course, heterozygous parent is by seeing that they can have big T and small T in their in the children. So the answer for this question is C. Okay, question 33. What is the definition of variation? You must be familiar with this. It's the differences between the individuals of the same species. Question 24, what is the feature of some xerophytes? So they are the desert plants, yeah? So large air spaces in the tissue, nope. Leaves roll out if a covered with hairs. Yeah, this is correct actually. Leaves stomata on the upper surface? Nope. Thin cuticle? Nope. Because they cannot lose water. Question 35. Where does the energy being transferred along a food chain originally come from? So this is initial, yeah. So a food chain is the sun being the primary source of energy. Okay. Question 36, which diagram shows a pyramid of biomass for a forest? So, pyramid of biomass is always pyramid shape. This is very fixed, really. They just want you to know what is the pyramid of biomass. So the answer is A. Question 37. Which substance is an enzyme used in fruit juice production? Pectinase. Question 38. The diagram shows some of the effects of human activity on the river. This is eutrophication. So what could have caused these effects? The overuse of fertilizer. So the answer is C. So this is the process of eutrophication. Question 39. The genetic modification has been used to produce human insulin and bacterial cell. What is inserted into the bacterial cell to produce human insulin? A recombinant insulin. Okay, because a recombinant is containing the bacteria plasmid plus the human plasmid. But then when it's recombined, it will be as a recombinant insulin already. Okay. Question 40, last question. Penicillin is made in a fermenter by growing organisms. Which type of organism is used in the production of penicillin? So technically, what is actually penicillin? Penicillin is coming from a fungus. Okay. So that's all for this paper. So I hope you understand everything and hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.